Hi students, let's continue with the congestion control algorithm. So in the previous video, I just explained the leaky bucket algorithm. What is the concept of leaky bucket? By taking a simple general example and the packets are flowing over the bucket. Now let's see the token bucket algorithm. So here this is the token bucket algorithm, the same concept of the leaky bucket, but only the thing is here, in order to deal with the bursty traffic that occurs in the leaky bucket, we need a flexible algorithm, okay, so that the data is not lost. The main concept in the token bucket algorithm is the data is not lost. We have to take care that whatever the data that is sending by the host computer will not be lost, will not be overflow. That is the concept of token bucket algorithm. In order to deal with the bursty traffic, so whatever that bursty traffic that is occurring in the leaky bucket, that will be overcome in the token bucket algorithm. So what it is doing, let's see the step by step. In regular intervals, tokens are thrown into a bucket. So one token added per tick. Okay, so one by one the tokens are thrown into the bucket F. So this is a bucket F. The bucket has a maximum capacity. A capacity will be allotted to the bucket. So whenever the capacity is full, it stops taking the tokens. Okay, whenever the capacity is full, it stops taking the tokens. Whenever it is reducing, then only it will take the bucket. So until the capacity is full, it holds all the tokens and send those tokens into the routers. Okay, so all the tokens are grouped into one packet and that packet will be sent to the destination. So one token added per ticket. Okay, so the bucket has a maximum capacity F. If there is a ready packet, a token is removed from the bucket. If a ready packet, a token is removed from the bucket. One token removed and discarded per cell transmitted. Okay, one token is removed from the bucket and the packet is sent. Suppose if there is no token in the bucket, let's take there is no token in the bucket, the packet cannot be sent. So whenever there is a token in the bucket, that packet will be sent. Okay, so here this is the arrival. Whenever it is full, it will be discarded, means it won't take any tokens. Otherwise, it sends into the queue and one after the another, the packet will be sent to the processor and it will be dispatched. So this is a token bucket algorithm. Let's see the difference between the leaky bucket and the token bucket so that you will be get a clear idea what exactly the leaky bucket was and the token bucket was. Leaky bucket is a discard packets. So what's leaky bucket will do? It discard packets. And whereas the token bucket does not discard packets, it discards only tokens. Just remember, token bucket discards only tokens, but leaky bucket discards complete packets. So with token bucket, a packet can only be transmitted if there are enough tokens to cover its length, its byte. Okay, so with token bucket, a packet can only be transmitted. A packet can only be transmitted if there are enough tokens to cover its length in bytes. Whereas in leaky bucket, it sends packets at an average rate. So it is simply sending the packets at an average rate. Okay, it's simply sending so that the bursting will be, it will be overflow. Okay, the bursty traffic is more in the leaky bucket. Whereas in the token bucket, only it can be transmitted if there are enough tokens, which covers its length in bytes. Token bucket allows for large burst to be sent faster by speeding up the output. And token bucket allows saving up tokens to send the large burst. Whereas leaky bucket does not allow saving. So this is the difference between leaky bucket and token bucket. Thank you.